Hello, hello, my beautiful friends. Welcome, welcome. It's Elizabeth Angeline coming at you live from Heaven, the Spa on the Rock. Tonight's topic is all about eye creams. So this is our Wednesday information video for you specifically to arm you with the best knowledge you can to make the best decision for your skincare choices. So today's topic, all about eye creams. Now we'll dive right in. It's 6 p.m. and I'm so excited to talk about this. I remember when I first started in the aesthetic industry, hi Madison, welcome. I was 19 years old and I remember thinking, whoa, if I start using an eye cream this early, I can't imagine what kind of preventative measures will be had. I'm almost 40, I'm 39, so I feel very happy with the eye zone area. Now, one of the main reasons that we need to use a very special eye cream or a designated eye cream is because the eye area is the thinnest tissue on our entire body. We do not have the same level of adipose tissue, which we have on the rest of our face, within the orbit of the bone. So you can imagine that any extrinsic aging, any stress, any pollution, any additional factors is all going to affect that area much more readily than the area that's plump and juicy with an adipose layer, the fat layer beneath. Also, without that fat layer, we have a closer vascular network to the surface of the skin. So any sun damage that comes in will cause more damage to the blood vessels and the collagen in there. So that can leave you with puffiness, darkness, pigmentation that you don't want, or just, of course, breaking down of the tissue leading to wrinkles. So that's kind of why we have to use a specific eye cream, as well as anyone who has a professional product or a scientifically studied product. They have particularly structured the molecules quite a bit finer. They can be termed sonic blasted molecules, micromolecules, things like that. So that area, the molecules will penetrate more efficiently because they are specifically formulated for the eye area. So I get asked all the time, could I use my moisturizer in your eye area? Yes, you may. But you also may experience some more milia around there or congestion around there. And if that is the case, then of course you wouldn't want to use that as much. What I do know though, is that if you have any of our Eminence serums, you may use those around the eye area. So you may use the Bright Skin Serum around the eye area, Firm Skin with the hyaluronic acid would be gorgeous, Calm Skin if you had any vascularity there. But we do have a very wide range of specifically formulated eye creams for you. So I'm going to pull out my catalog. I don't know if I can show you my catalog because one of my other videos got flagged with content that was someone else's, but that being said, I got a ton of products behind me, so we shall see. One thing that I might introduce you to, which is kind of fun, is the fact that your eye care can begin with your eye makeup remover. So a lot of us would use our normal cleanser for removing our eye makeup, which is fine. Obviously, all of our cleansers are gentle and safe for the eye area. P.S. If you're here watching me live, let me know. Drop me a heart down below so that I know you're here and I'm not talking to myself. I really appreciate your time. This, if you suffer with kind of like heavy eyes or tired eyes at the end of your day, or where you're just like, get this makeup off my face, I highly encourage you to consider the makeup remover. Obviously, you need to have pads with it to do it, but it's thank you very much. I appreciate the hearts more than I can say. I encompass the iPad with the cooling, and it is just this incredible release. It's cool, it's soothing. Botanical ingredients really help to drain, but also hydrate and desensitize the area. At the end of the day, I can't stress enough how much I love using this. I accentuate my eyes, as you can see, so I do put a couple of coats of mascara on there. So this for me is just a lovely at the end of the day. And then if you're having a rushed time and you don't want to wash your face, turn your cotton pads over and give yourself a wipe, off you go. This stuff is so good. Super inexpensive as well. Big bottle of it, 2 pumps, beautiful product. Okay. So once your eye area is clean, then you want to begin with choosing your eye product based on your needs. So if you have wrinkles, you would perhaps want a richer cream. If you're starting off in the preventative family, you would perhaps have a lighter texture. You also want to consider when you're going to apply it and how you would like to apply it. So I will show you some of the ones I have on hand, and it gives you an idea of how you would use them. So one of them, we have two different ones that come in pots like this. Let me know you're here with me live. I love that you're here. Thank you so much for watching. So if you like a pot, obviously you can stick your finger, well, a stick but your finger, right into this jar. So a lot of people like this because they perceive it to have no waste, which is great. And I love the glass. This particular one is snow mushroom. Snow mushroom is like nature's hyaluronic acid. It holds and binds moisture to your skin. But if you can see, this is a very thick cream. So this would not be very good for any oily skin types, and it probably wouldn't be very good for any really intensely sensitive skin types. You would probably feel that weight of that product on there. But what I'm showing you right now is the option of the jar. So yes, you can certainly get a lot out of it, but I also find sometimes you can overuse it. So you dip your finger or your stick in there, and then you kind of have extra and you're like putting it back in there. So just be really careful. We have organic ingredients. We don't have preservatives, so we don't really want stuff to get in there, especially water. That being said, you can, once you have it in your hand, you can put a little bit of water into it. Hello, France. And you can put it on that way if you want to break the texture down. So let's say you have an oilier skin, but you're very concerned about wrinkles, then this guy would be really great. So I'm going to go over afterwards kind of what each cream would be beneficial for, but right now I'm just showing you the containers. So we have Bearberry Eye Cream and Snow Mushroom in that one. The other option is this lovely pump. So the pump is my favorite because you can learn to negotiate just how much you need. Now, when you pump a full Eminence pump out, I mean, that is like 6 people's eye cream. So it's way too much. You have to learn to kind of negotiate just like a touch, right? So full depression versus what you can figure out. This is also a beautiful glass jar and nothing can go into this. This is the Neroli Eye Serum. I love this product. And then we have a rollerball option. Really, really good again for puffy eyes. If you have this particular one, is also extremely generous when the product comes out. So we go real slow and then you roll it into place. This is quite a cooling metal ball. This is just lovely. And so you can roll that on, and I'll talk about the hibiscus eye shortly because it's quite special. And then you have these, we have several of these giant pump ones. So these giant pump ones, this is my personal one. This marine peptide eye is outstanding. And again, I'll go into it particularly why. This particular one has lasted me over 9 months. Exceptional value when you learn about not giving a full depression there. So those are the container types that we have for eye cream. So you do want to choose if you're going to want a roller ball for something really cooling, or if you want to have your finger in there so that you can really get the work of that, or if you're comfortable with one of the pumps and then you can negotiate how much comes out, but then you're not getting your fingers into it. And so really your personal habits do matter, because consistently across the board, Eminence has outstanding ingredients in all of the eye creams. And so really, if you are taking a jar home and then you get it home and you've got these long fingernails, then your personal habit is going to get into the way of using it, right? Or if you really like using the roller ball and I send you home with a pump, then you're like, it might not use it as much as if it suited some of your personal habits. So just keep that in mind when you're choosing an eye cream. So the next thing that we want to focus on is when you would use it during the day. So I use an eye cream both day and night. You can have different textures for day and night. So if you are wearing makeup and you want to have a primed eye area, then I would go with a Neroli Eye Serum. It's not too heavy. It allows you to put your makeup on quite quickly after your skincare routine, and it doesn't add a barrier. If you had excessively dry skin, I would definitely recommend the Snow Mushroom, because it is so rich and so fluffy and so nourishing that you can feel that right away. And the rest of the day, your eye area will be quite calm and quite hydrated, which is quite lovely. So I would use an eye cream both day and night in your morning and AM and PM routine if you could. But if you found that for any reason your eyes were more sensitive in the day, then definitely get your eye cream on there at nighttime. In some of our consultations, you guys, we've been chatting about the reason why nighttime is almost more important than daytime. Even if in the daytime you just rinsed your face off with a Tonique and put your SPF on, I would be quite happy with that. Your nighttime routine is when your skin is restructuring itself and taking in more ingredients as opposed to defending itself against the day. So we've been learning a lot about how we can get a very basic daytime routine for the speed of your skincare as well, but then really getting some nourishing ingredients at night. So if that's the case, then definitely find something to use at nighttime for eye. And again, you could have a lighter one in the day and then a nice rich one at nighttime as well. It completely depends on what your skin's goals are and where you're at with your aging process. We all start to degrade our collagen from the time we're 20 and on. It just genetically depends on how quickly that shows up in your face and especially around your eyes, because that's today's topic. So if I were to have my favorite eye cream, let's say, it's kind of tricky because I love them all. I personally, I actually took this one and this one and this one from my home. So this is Barry's favorite. He loves this product. I kind of don't. I don't want to say that, but I kind of don't. It's very heavy for me because I'm a combination skin type. He is a more rosacea-y red tendency. He's got very thin, almost dry skin. He loves this. And in fact, when he comes out of the bathroom for his nighttime routine, I swear my husband is like the only man on the planet. Put your hand up if your boyfriend or your husband has a nighttime routine. Like, let me know. He comes out of there, however long, 10 minutes later, and he's got this like almost like an eye mask around of snow mushroom. And if you're going to do that with it, oh, it's gorgeous for that, because those ingredients are going to grab moisture from around the area and hold them into the eye area. So I always tease him because he looks adorable, but that's a beautiful solution for that because it's fluffy, kind of a whipped texture. So I didn't get any feedback on that. I guess you guys don't have boyfriends that have any. I'll have to tell Barry that because he'll be like, you know what? I don't mind. He's a good man. If you have a combination oily skin type, I would go with the Neroli Eye Serum. It's a beautiful, this is the one here, lightweight, so silky, natural retinol alternative. So for those of us with combo oily skin, we love those words. Natural retinol alternative, stimulating collagen. Across the board, you guys, most of the eye creams are going to stimulate collagen, but I did want to touch base, if you're not using Eminence, on some ingredients that you want to keep your eyes out for. So you can have a specifically formulated eye cream with an AHA in it. They're usually very subtle. You can also have a retinol in your eye cream. We use the retinol alternative, of course, but that cellular turnover, that signal to the lower levels of the skin to increase the skin's plumpness and hydration. Vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin E, integral moisture up for that area. You also, thank God, Amir. Barry actually, what did he used to use on his face? Shampoo. When I first met Barry, he used to use shampoo on his face. I was like, that's not happening. Now look at him, oh my God. Ceramides. Ceramides hold moisture into your tissue, similar to hyaluronic acid. You want that in there too. So ingredients that you're watching out for to ensure that your eye cream can do something. If you have dark circles concerned, then you want to have some sort of iron in there, or caffeine. You want to have caffeine in your eye cream. That's what makes hibiscus eye very special. So hibiscus eye is one of these products. Hello, Shannon, my lovely friend. Hibiscus eye is one of these products that has such an incredible tensor kind of effect. So when you put it on, you can do one side and there's actually a difference. I think it's 3 minutes later. So it tightens the skin, it drains the eye area, and you've got this really cooling, very comfortable rollerball situation for the application. And so if you did have a heavier bag or just a heavier feeling around the eye area, I would recommend hibiscus. That being said, you would only want, you need to use hibiscus in the day. Because of that tensor effect, you wouldn't really need to use that at nighttime because nobody can see you. So this particular one would be an excellent one above and below the eye zone, and it would cause that lifting that we love, and then everything else would go on top of that. So if you had hibiscus, which is why I have, you might go for something at nighttime that would signal the collagen to maintain, as well as help to turn over and correct the cells. So that would be the Marine Peptide Serum. I'm sorry, Eye Serum. This guy, oh my gosh! He's got the Smart Collagen Complex, which contains some algaes as well. Peptides are in here from some of those algaes. And stem cells. Oh my goodness. So this guy is what I refer to as the heavy hitter. If you're thinking, holy smokes, I've never used an eye cream, I'm above 40 years old, this is the guy we're going for. So Marine Collagen, again, really large tube. Its value is a bit higher of an investment, but again, they last up to 9 months because you're just negotiating a tiny little bit coming out. So this investment is one of those ones that ranges about anywhere from $10 to $12 a month when you plan it out for 9 months, which I think is outstanding. I love the generosity of the size of those eye creams because you buy that kind of once in a year and you're using it the entire time. You're using it to defend, you're also using it to plump, but also using it to hydrate and look really good. So there's a multitude of reasons we need an eye cream. And you also can get a double whammy every time you use your eye cream. You can also use it around the vermilion of your lip. It's a very similar thin layer there, and it can really benefit around those lip lines. And particularly if you're a really big fan of bold lip colors, then the hibiscus around that area will help thin out, reduce the appearance of the lines there with the tensor effect, and then your lip line will be really, really sharp, which I think looks so, so good. Bearberry is a beautiful ingredient for brightening of the skin, so do keep your eye out for bearberry. We have a bearberry repair cream, which is very rich, very nourishing, very beautiful as well, also in a pot family. Peptides we talked about, ceramides holding moisture. Yeah, so we talked about the ingredients that you want to have in your eye cream. Caffeine and a stimulant like iron is one of those things that helps flush old blood out. And so by flushing that old blood flow out, then you're getting new fresh blood flow in and a reduction of the visibility of that darkness. So I've kept this on my hand. This is neroli because I want to show you how I would use it. Today, what have I got on? Lots of self-tanner on today and some blush, so I shouldn't look too crazy. Again, you can see a full depression is just way too much. So I always apply our eye cream with the ring finger. It's the most gentle finger. Whatever you have chosen, if it's your pot or your pump, you would put it just onto the finger. You wouldn't start with the back of your hand. So you put the one pump onto your finger, we put the two together, and then you just dab them into place around the orbit of your eye bone. So when you apply it, you're using an inward motion, and you can do the upper brow as well. And you're focusing on wherever your signs of aging are. So if you have a farther out wrinkle, then off you go, farther out. If it's lower down, off you go down there. And then always, always the vermilion of your lip with whatever excess you have. And if you can get into that double habit of using it, you're getting a double whammy for value from your investment, but also you're preventing any wrinkling around that area. Plus this particular one smells so good. That's the neroli eye serum. So that's a lightweight serum. Some guests that I have would also go ahead and put a lavender on top of that, or the cucumber on top of that. The cucumber is a very cooling, very soothing, very basic. So if you were, let's say you're in your 20s and you get come across this video and you think, wow, do I need an eye cream? Yes. Everybody should be wearing an eye cream because that area degrades so much faster, unless you want to have, you know, non-protecting that zone, that's great too. But if you're concerned about onset of aging as you move forward, then just find something very light, very simple that maintains your moisture levels and your collagen levels to be active. So cucumber would be great for that. Wild plum would be great. Neroli is divine. But you can find those eye creams sometimes without as many intense ingredients like the heavy hitters that I refer to, like the collagen complex or the retinol alternatives. You don't necessarily need that when you're 19 or 20 years old, but if you can get into the habit of treating your eye area with something like the cucumber, the lavender, or the wild plum, then at least you're in the habit of it and you'll always be doing it, and you're preventing, which is way easier than moving forward to remove. So or reduce. So do we need more than one? I think that covers that question. If you had different preferences between day and night, then perhaps you would have two different eye creams. You generally do not need to layer eye creams unless you have had a really serious eye issue. And those eye issues would be, again, dark circles, or maybe even post-eye surgery. If you had an eye surgery around that zone, you could potentially have a treatment healing serum and then a hydration serum, but that would be very specific. Not usually does one need more than one eye cream at a time. So as I say, like hibiscus for day would be fantastic, and then a rich snow mushroom at night would be lovely. And then also keep in mind your other habits. So if you're doing something like, again,